So sabai.
Thank you very much for inviting me to share some experience in Bangkok, particularly with the Hong Sin Hai and other colleagues who are inviting me to be here. So I will have 40 minutes to say something about property market in Thailand. As an example, actually, I think Mr. Hong Sin Hai can do a very good research in Phnom Penh himself. But this is just some example only. You see, this is a man and elephant. Normally, we don't know, if we are blind, we don't know what elephant is like. If we touch the tail, maybe we describe something. If we touch the head, maybe we describe another thing. But if we can touch the whole body, and piece by piece, we will be able to know what is the elephant. So this is research. If we conduct the research properly, we should know what are happening. But if we don't conduct it properly or just partly, we may not know the fact. And this is what Mr. Hong Sin Hai and VTrust are trying to conduct this sort of research. We hope everyone will support him and VTrust on this. This is me, yeah. But it doesn't look like me because I'm too old already. I should update my photo. Maybe I use this one, should be better. So I'm the president of the Thai Preso Foundation, and also this is our agency for real estate affairs. We conduct valuation, something similar to VTrust. So we are allies in this region. And this is we are the business house information center in Thailand since 1994. But we are not a broker. I know that broker like agent like St. Julius, everyone will be really rich. But for us, we are just a researcher and value so that we stay neutral. And we also conducted research and valuation in different other countries as well. We also have our colleagues from Sanju from Japan. They are also our allies in Japan. So sometimes when we go to conduct valuation in Hokkaido, we also have some cooperation, or sometimes they come to Thailand. If you need any valuation or something in Japan, don't forget Sanju. Three friends. First, let me tell you something about the situation of different countries. This is the estimation from the IMF. The IMF said that in our region, the growth of the GDP is growing quickly compared to other parts of the world. You see, they are growing like Cambodia. Wow, 7% per annum, 6% or something. This is a big leapfrog that will be growing quickly. So I should move to Cambodia. I told my friend that if my grandma 80 years ago moved from mainland China to Cambodia, maybe we met earlier. But my grandma, I don't know, she moved to Thailand. That's why we moved later, we met later. You can see here that Thailand is here. Among these 10 countries, Thailand is the growth is one of the smallest, except Singapore. Singapore may be the lowest, but Singapore per capita income is a lot higher than Bangkok, maybe 7 times higher than Bangkok, maybe around 20 times higher than Bangkok, higher than in Phnom Penh. Say if the income, the minimum wage in Phnom Penh, $10 per day, in Singapore maybe almost 20 times. So that is in the case of Singapore, but their growth rate may be slower. So this is the case. So since 2019, Singapore will be the lowest in the 10 countries, followed by Thailand, number 9. But Singapore, but Cambodia, and Indonesia, Laos, Vietnam, Malaysia, or even Indonesia are growing quickly. Like now in Thailand, our interest rate, the deposit interest rate is only 1.5% only, really low. Yeah, maybe 6.5%. So I should move my money to India. But in Japan, maybe minus. Yeah, that will be another story. So this is different in different country. But we can see from here that since the year 2019, it takes 4 or 5 years, Cambodia is growing really quickly. So this is something promising for Cambodia. So I think what Mr. Siha and the team said should be very correct, that in the future, Cambodia will be the land of hope for the future. So this is the same. We can see that we just interpret this table to be this figure only, the same. The red one is Thailand. Now we are number 8, number 9. So this is what is happening. In the past, maybe number 8, because Brunei is lower than Thailand, but now Brunei is growing quickly. But Brunei is a very small country. They have only 400,000 people, less than one sangkat in Phnom Penh. So very small. This is the case of Bangkok. You can see that we conducted the survey since 1994. In 1994, January, we conducted the survey. Anyone has gone yet in 1994? Mr. Sinha already born, but still at that time, very young. 1994, and then every year. This is the crisis in the year 1997, 99, and 2000. This is not many developments, and growing up again, up and down. So if we see the details in every part of the year, maybe we cannot see the vision, because we need to see the panoramic view. This is the panoramic view. We can see up and down. This is in the number of units launched every year, every month. The number of units launched is very important. So if the market situation is bad, there will be no more launching. But if the market is very good, there will be a lot of launching. The construction is not the case. Sometimes maybe the market is really bad already, but because of the contract, they may be still building the projects, but there may be no more market, because the market was really bad. This is in terms of the value of the development every year, now going up a lot. Last year, they are growing very quickly. You see, a lot more than 10 years ago or 20 years ago. But in the case of number of units, you can see that although in the past maybe a lot, now not many. But in terms of value, you can see that now a lot. In the past, maybe not many. So we are not building cheaper units. Now we are going to high price. But the cycle of Cambodia may be different. Now, during the past 10 years or 15 years, you may build upper income houses, because lower income people still have no money to buy. But right now, maybe we have to build lower income housing, because the lower middle income are growing. And in the future, maybe something like Bangkok, that now we do not build any lower income housing anymore, because that will be too cheap. So we build a higher income group who can afford. So we are in a different cycle in the real estate market. Maybe in Bangkok, maybe a little in advance. This is the number of projects happening. These are the number of projects. You can see that There are around 2,000 projects every year in Bangkok. This is Bangkok. Actually, this is five provinces. There are five city provinces, something like Jakarta. Jakarta, they have Jabodetabek, Jakarta, Bekasi, Depok, or something. All together, five cities. This is also the same, the Bangkok metropolitan region. Bangkok alone is in the city. Yeah. But you can see in the heart of the city, there are a lot. Outside may not be a lot because not many tollway, not many railroad or sky train or subway. So in the fringe, maybe not many Europeans, but mostly are in the city. Altogether, there are around 2,000. If you do not believe, you can come and count. There should be around 2,000. So this is the largest. In Jakarta, there are only around 600 projects currently for sale, but here there are 2,000. In Manila, there are around 300. In Ho Chi Minh City and Hanoi, there may be around 200, no more than 250. In Phnom Penh, maybe around 200 or less. But here is the largest number, the 2,000 projects. You may know that in Bangkok, it's very most popular for Chinese. 3 years ago, Bangkok may be number, Thailand may be number five. Number one may be New Zealand, Australia, or Chinese. 2 years ago, maybe Bangkok or Thailand become number three. But now, Bangkok become number one for Chinese investors. Why? Because in Thailand, we have no limit. In New Zealand, today they said that for foreigners, for Chinese or any foreigners, cannot buy a house in New Zealand anymore. Because New Zealand, they have only 4 million people. Although they have 80 million sheep, but they have only 4 million people. So they are afraid of being taken over by China or something. So they don't allow. In Australia, they just allow for people who buy their first-hand housing. Second-hand house cannot touch. In Malaysia, they said that you can buy a house, but at least it must be around, say, $300,000. In Singapore, they said if you buy a house in Singapore, actually an apartment, you have to pay 25% or 70% of tax. But in Thailand, no tax. So many people like to buy in Thailand, something similar to Phnom Penh. But so right now, all these units, maybe 80% bought by the local people, another 20% by foreigners, like Chinese foreigners or other Westerners. But a lot of Chinese coming, because in Thailand, we just allow them to buy no harm. Maybe if my grandmother did not move from mainland China to Thailand 18 years ago, maybe by now I may come to Thailand or Phnom Penh to buy properties. So this is the launching 2 years ago. This is, this is last year. You see, in 1 year, there are around 457 projects. A lot indeed. So I but the sign here maybe not so nice, sorry. But this is the unit, the projects that launched last year, 457 projects. In 1 year, so many. So last year it was a boom. And if it was a boom last year, if this year another boom, there may be some bubble burst. Fortunately, in January, February, and March of this year, the supplies are very small, so that they can adjust, the market will be adjusted. The backlog in the market will be absorbed by the buyers. So there will be no new, not many new projects. During the past, during the first quarter of 2019. So this is a good sign. If there are still a lot of development, there may be bubble burst soon. But right now, the new developments are not many. But this was last year. You can see if we subdivide into different groups like detached house, semi-detached, townhouse. This is considered low rise. And chop houses in Bangkok, there are many, not many, very little, very few. In 15 years ago, when we came to conduct a survey of housing in Phnom Penh, we found that 2/3 of the housing supply in back in Phnom Penh were chop houses. But right now, maybe 1/3 only. But in the past, there were a lot. And most of the products are apartments. We call condominiums. Condominiums, they are maybe high-priced condominiums. But if for cheaper one, we call apartments. But in Bangkok, even although high price or low price, we all call them condominiums. So there are a lot more here. Even in the case of Pattaya, the resort city, maybe 70% apartments. But Bangkok, only more than half only. If it is in the case of Ho Chi Minh City, Hanoi, maybe 95% apartments. Not many other land subdivisions or something, not very few. But in Thailand, we still say that it is around, say, no less than, no more than 60%. Still not many. We still have a lot of low-rise residents in the fringe of Bangkok. Yeah. And there may be some other thing like land subdivisions, but not many. And this house price, this is in number of million baht. Say, more than 20 million baht in around $600,000. There are not many, but most of them are apartments. Some apartments in Bangkok may be around $2 million. The most expensive one in Bangkok, the Borei, it is around $10 million. There are only 30 units. $10 million per unit. If you want to go to visit, you have to write your name in the website, in the email or something. If they see the one who want to see the project, mean call Sokhon Kon Chok Chai my name, they will say no, because they know that they have no $10 million to buy. They will allow those millionaire to have a look around 30 units, okay, 10 million baht per unit. Maybe I would like to be their gardener. Maybe they are very rich. Or some apartments in Bangkok who are very luxury. Every apartment, they have their own swimming pool. You like to swim? Maybe you like. But swimming pool, that is very fashionable. Maybe at the beginning, people like to swim in their own swimming pool. But later on, those swimming pool equipped with every unit may be outdated. The people will not use it anymore. Because normally people will swim for other people to have a look, watch. If no one watch, they won't swim. So in the future, that may be outdated. But every unit, they equipped with a swimming pool. So that is very luxury in Bangkok. But there are not many. And this is only for those already sold or something. You can see that we put it like this is the overall supply. This is the value of the development. You can see 20 billion. Oh, a lot. This is around $2 billion. $2 billion. A lot of money. But for the cheaper one, there may be around 36,000 units, around 21,000 units, but altogether it's just only $1 billion only. So higher price, less, smaller number of units, but high price. But for the lower income group, maybe very cheap units, not many now. So this is what happening in Bangkok. So now we are catering for those upper income group, because for the lower income group, there are not many demand. This is on annual basis. A moment ago, I showed you on monthly basis. This is on annual basis. You can see last year a big growth. 78% in terms of units, in terms of value, and around almost 10% in terms of units. This means that this is a boom last year. It was a boom last year, but our economy may not be really strong, but it was a boom because the upper income group can still afford to buy a house, but the lower income group maybe they may not be able to buy a house, but there are big boom here for last year. Actually, when they have a boom, this year there should be another boom, next year another boom, maybe booming will be for 3 years altogether, and then it will go down. But for this year, there may be different. Maybe if there is a boom this year again, there may be a bubble burst because the supply is growing, but the demand may be shrinking because of the fighting between China and USA. Maybe this may make the development, the demand from abroad may be shrinking. If the demand from abroad, from China and other countries are shrinking, this may be problematic for our local markets. So we have to be very careful. That's why during the past 3 months, first quarter of 2019, there are not many new developments because they are prepared to be soft landing. You see the price per unit is around 4 million baht. This is a price in the past may be really cheap, but now higher price. During the past 25 years, the construction cost may increase only one time, but the land price increased around 5 times. So this is another fact. Land price growing quickly, growing very quickly. I have some information for you how much is a piece of land in Bangkok later. But you can see the property price growing up quite quickly, but mostly the price of land, not the price of consumption. The cost of consumption just one time grows only. One thing that you will face, that is the public company. You have the public company. This is public company. This is the subsidiary of public companies, and this is private company. So public company and the subsidiary of public companies all together become 3/4 of the market. We have around 50 public company, listed company in the stock exchange of Thailand. They occupy around 3/4 of the market. So this means that smaller developers are forced to be for survival somehow. Big companies will be more influential. So if you are developers, you need to be in the listed company so that you have more money, you have more power and more capital. Say if you have lending money from the bank, the interest rate may be around 7%. But if you acquire money from the stock market, the cost of capital may be only 3%. So this means that if you are a listed company, you will be more privileged. You will save more money than the small companies. So this is the tendency that in the future, smaller companies will be hard to survive. So you have to be really professional if you are small companies. So this is the case of Bangkok. I talked with our colleagues from Japan, Mr. Kainuma. Mr. Kainuma, he said, I'll finish in 1 hour. 10 minutes. Yeah, in 10 minutes. I will be very big. So in the future, big companies will be more influential. Something similar to Japan as well. The fourth full company, you occupy around 30%, right? Yeah, so this is a very important. And this is also a similar figures. In our analysis, you can see that which locations are very good, which locations are not good. Like this location, there are no new development. No new development. So this means that it is no demand. No supply means no demand, okay? And this is a zone with a lot of demand. So this is a very good. This is a zone with the unit sold very quickly. So this is also very promising. And these are the locations. We should be able to identify. We divide Bangkok into 78 locations. 78 locations. So this will be very important. Which location is better? Which market is better? Which market is worse? So that we can make comparison. Otherwise, the general picture may be one thing. We need to know in details in different locations because developers are in different locations. So you need to identify different locations for different developers. These are the name of those big developers. So these are the locations that decrease a lot. Property price decrease a lot. If it is decrease a lot, it means that it is very bad. You see, decreasing, very bad. But if the price increasing, this means that the property market is very good. So this is some indicator. These are in the city condominium or apartments. In the cities, in Bangkok and Phnom Penh are big different because in Phnom Penh, there is no mass transit. But in Bangkok, we have mass transit. But in Tokyo, maybe a lot more mass transit. So property price depending on the mass transit a lot. Another city that may be experiencing a lot, you may be like Jakarta. Now they have some one new sky train, another new subway coming, so that will be a transformation in Jakarta. But in Phnom Penh, still not, because you still don't have mass. Oh, sorry. So to make you up. So you, this is the property price going up and down, and up again. But if it is in the case of Tokyo, maybe up and down, and something up, something like Fujiyama. But yeah, it is going up again, fortunately. So this is what happened. You see, last year, land price going up for almost 8%. Because of the construction of new mass transit, new sky train, new subway. So this is really promising. That's why property price going up. It doesn't mean that our economy is good, but it just means that there are new construction of the new mass transit. So if we want to invest, we need to be nearby the sky train station. This is the most expensive one, Siam Square. 2.5 million baht per square. Wow, it is around 600,000 baht per square meters, or maybe around 20,000 US dollar per square meter. Here you use square meter, right? Square meter. Yeah, 20,000 baht per square meters. Ah, sorry, 20,000 US dollar per square meter. Very expensive. We our bank notes 1,000 baht. We have to lie down 7 times to be at that amount of money. Yeah, so we sit on the pile of money. So this is very expensive because it is there are mass transit. There are 2 lines of mass transit here. So these are the most expensive one. The increase last year, you see, some increase very quickly in 1 year because of the mass transit. And this is the new line coming. You see, every station, this is the property price. So we conduct the survey every year. So we know what are happening in different locations. If you want to buy property so that you earn a lot, come to Bangkok. We have a lot of information for you. Ah, Mr. Wong Sing has said that I should say something about other countries. This is in Bali. I just told you this because I just walked from the airport, from the hotel to the airport. 12 kilometers to reduce my weight. But it won't help because afterwards I eat a lot. But one thing I tell you is that in Indonesia, it is growing really quickly. So if you want to invest abroad, Indonesia, according to our survey, we found that Indonesia is number one for investment.
according to our survey, I conducted a survey in different countries. We found that this country, particularly Jakarta, is the best. This is Beijing. I was there last year. You see this man looks like me. My friend did inform me. If China go can see it, I may be in big trouble. Yeah, my friend did it for me. So one thing is that in China, people are afraid that their economy may be bad or worsening in the future. But I believe not. Their economy is very strong. I went to Shanghai and Beijing last year to meet many people, and we found that they are still very, very strong. No problem for them. Maybe we are overestimating. But after the era of China, in the future, there may be India. Because in the next 10 years, the population of India may be a lot, maybe more than China, population in China. So in the future, maybe the next wave may be India. That may be in the next 20 years or something. But China is still very strong, in our opinion. This is in Laos. We went to Laos next year, next month I will go to Laos again to conduct some variation class there. But they are growing a lot. But the problem for Laos is that they have only 7 million people, the same number of the Phnom Penh only. So their population are very, very small. That's why they are battery of Asia. They can produce a lot of energy, but not many people there. So the opportunity for growth may be a lot smaller than in Phnom Penh. So if you want to invest, maybe Phnom Penh should be a lot better. And this is myself in Turkey. Fortunately, I did not fall down. In Turkey right now, you may know that the inflation is very high. Have you ever heard the inflation is 20%? In some years, the inflation are 40%. So this is very bad. If we invest in this sort of country, in Spain or Portugal or Turkey or something, that may be very risky. But property price right now is very attractive. That is another story. And in Hong Kong, I just went there recently. And now they are very aggressive in investment abroad. This is the overseas property something alliance. They are investing a lot in other countries. 20 years ago, Hong Kong GDP may be around 20%, one fifth of China GDP. But now Hong Kong GDP is only 3% of the whole China. Now they are moving abroad a lot. So if we want to attract investors, I think Hong Kong is a very good place to attract those investors. Maybe my 10 minutes is almost over. Let me go more quickly. Yeah, this is Malaysia. I was there 2 weeks ago. And now their growth are very small, very slow. Although they have new government, but their growth are very small, very small and slow. Oh, one thing is that I have one questionnaire for you. Have you seen in your paper on your table? It's a small questionnaire. Maybe you can just answer so that I can process this and send it back to you. But I wrote Yang Kon. My secretary still put it Yang Kon. I will go back and punish him because he put Yang Kon. Actually, it should be Phnom Penh. Correct it to be Phnom Penh and answer for meetings. And then lunch, and you correct it, just put on the table. Last, this is in Yang Kon. Last week, I was there. Here is also compared to Phnom Penh. I believe that compared to Phnom Penh, this is slow. In the past, they are growing very quickly. But during the past 2 years, last year and year before last, development are very slow. There are not many new projects, unlike in Phnom Penh. In Phnom Penh, you see so many new projects, but in Yang Kon, there are less. Even if their population are very, a lot more than in Phnom Penh. the whole country may be around 60 million. You may know that in Yangon, if you build an apartment for the first 7 floor, no need to have a lift. What about in Phnom Penh? In Bangkok, for the first 5 stories, no need to have a lift. But in Yangon, 7 floor, no lift. What about here? 7 floor?
Okay.
Yeah. So this means that Yangon people are very strong. They can walk up 7 floor. Oh, very strong. That's why they defeat Thailand twice in the history. So, but they are growing very slowly compared to Phnom Penh. This is what we saw in yeah. So, this is my presentation. This is a photo already. But once I came here to conduct variation teaching, maybe in 2008 and 2010, 2012 or something. Also recently. So if you can be my friend in the WhatsApp also, and kindly answer the question so that I can do some processing. And also I will send you the results that I process, that I collect the information in Yangon, in Kuala Lumpur to you as well, so that you will know what are happening. And you are experts in property markets in Phnom Penh in Cambodia, so you should be able to write out some information for me, but particularly for those from Century 21. You should be really expert in this field, so kindly answer some questions for me. If you found Yangon, I mean Phnom Penh, they did not check it properly, sorry about that. So thank you very much. Chok Sapai.
Dr. Sopon Kontuchai for your informative and interesting speech.